Hi, and welcome to the fifth part of the Simple Character Controller series. Today we will be adding some simple jump functionality to our character controller. Before doing anything else, let's open up Unity and our input actions we set up in the first episode. You might have already guessed it, but we're creating a new action now by clicking on the plus sign next to actions here, and we can just call it jump. Our jump action will be of type button, so let's just bind it to the spacebar. Click on the no binding option here, then on the path dropdown, and finally the listen button. Tap on the spacebar on your keyboard and choose it here. Save the asset and let's move on to the player controller script again. Let's first create a method for jumping, similar to what we did in the first episode. You might think that we don't need a callback context here, since we're only checking whether or not the spacebar has been pressed. However, we have three properties to listen to that could be relevant. Started, meaning when we first press the key. Performed, which doesn't do much here, but it would essentially check whether or not you're still holding down the spacebar. And then cancelled, which is fired when we lift our finger from the key. So, what we can do is to only run this method when we have pressed the key down and ignore the rest of the states. If not context.started, then return. Let's also create a serialized variable of type float up here and call it jump power. One thing we can do immediately is to check whether or not the character controller is grounded, otherwise the player will be able to jump forever. And since we've already used this check here in the apply gravity method, I'm just going to move it to a separate method to make it cleaner. This is just a personal preference, so if you don't like it this way, you can just call characterController.isGrounded. Down here, I'll just type private bool isGrounded and return characterController.isGrounded. This here will just return a boolean, meaning we can now call isGrounded instead of characterController.isGrounded. I'll change this in the applyGravity method as well. So in the jump method we can now check if isGrounded, and since we don't want to do anything when the character controller is not, we can invert this if statement and just return. If not isGrounded, return. And how do we get our character to jump now? It's really easy. Velocity plus equals jump power. That's really all it takes. Let's jump back into Unity. Click on the player input object in the hierarchy. Click on events, gameplay, and here in jump, click the plus sign and drag your character object with the player controller script attached to it into the object field here. And in the functions dropdown, choose player controller and then jump up here. Choose your character object and set the jump power to 4 to begin with. I will also set my gravity multiplier down to 1 for now. These are values you'll need to play around with to find what's good for your game. Hit play and make sure your character is jumping now. We can move around this level and jump back onto the platform. If you have any questions or requests, let me know. I think the next video might be about double jumping. The code for this project is now updated on GitHub and the link is down in the description. Thanks for watching and I'll see you in the next one.